Hey, and welcome back. In this video, I want to show you how to add a Calendly embed booking link, whatever you would call it, to your Webflow website. So let's imagine on my personal website here, we want to create a page in which people can book a call with me. So let's first start by creating this page. And to do that, I just wanted to duplicate my my main page, and then I can just now delete everything despite the navbar and the footer. And now we want to create a section in between, and we want to use the Calendly embed now. So for now, we will go to the Calendly page, and let's say we want to have 60 minutes with Max. We click on the share button here, and then we go to add to website. And there are three different ways on how to do it. There's an inline embed, so really showing the booking page of Calendly inside your website, a pop-up widget, so a button that's flowing around, something like this, and a pop-up text. In my case here, I want to make sure that we are using the inline embed, and we can click on this one and create this little HTML and JavaScript snippet. Okay, so two or three interesting or important things here. First of all, you can customize whatever this embed looks like. I will just show you the main version as it is right now with the text color and button link color. And then later on, we can customize it and see if we want to change it. So if I have created this section here on my website, first of all, here, I just wanted to make sure to give it a little bit of not margin, but padding. So give it a little bit of space to breathe to the top and to the bottom here. And now we want to use the embed. So the code embed thing. And we are going to paste in our Calendly now here. And there's no preview for that because it's JavaScript that's loaded. So it's only shown if you actually publish to your staging or if you publish to production. So in our case, we can now quickly just test it out by publishing to the staging. And then we can take a look of how our Calendly embed looks like. So really easy till now, but the customizing is more the harder part. We can see, okay, book a call. Here the Calendly embed is already loading on my website. It also shows the background color white. It shows every button basically in blue. And that's really, really easy for now. Obviously, if you want to see how it looks on a smaller screen, you can either just like make it a little bit smaller as here in the example. Or you can also obviously just use the dev tools. If you click on your browser here and then you go to more tools, developer tools, this would pop up. And here you can quickly just put it away. And the dimensions here, for example, choose the iPhone XR to see how it looks on that one. Okay, but now we want to make sure that we are customizing our embed a little bit. So let's reload this one and close our dev tools for a second. Okay, we are back. And now if we go back to the Calendly embed, we can do a couple of things. So first of all, we can change the background color. And the background color, for example, for my website here, let's take a look what that is, would be, let's go to the body and see what the color is. Okay, so this hex code, and I can now put it easily in here. It will be changed. And the button and link color, so maybe we want to have something that is more like this grayish color, so dark slate gray. It's something that we can easily adapt now. One second, dark slate gray, we want to customize. Okay, we want to have this value here. I click in, now here I change it, copy the code again. And as you can see, this background color, text color, and button link color are changed inside my Calendly embed. So you could also do it yourself, but obviously with this tool, it's a little bit easier. We are going back to the code embed, paste this, save, publish to staging. And now you can see that the Calendly embed will look a little bit different. So let's see, we changed it. Okay. Background color is now the same. Everything here is gray. So as we wanted it. Just one little side note, if you are working with these embeds, so there are a couple of things that are important to you. Obviously, I already said the colors that you can customize, but also the height and width of your embed. So for example, in my case here, we have the min width is 320 pixels and the height is 700 pixel. So what you will see on the website here is 320 minimum and 700 high. Obviously, I can make this also a little bit, I can adapt this. So let's imagine we just want to have the min width the min width could also be higher. Wouldn't make a difference now because it is already expanding a little bit, but I changed the height. So you will see the logic here. And then obviously you can adapt it to the size of the box or your web design that you have. I reload and now you can see here my embed that I have is bigger than before. And like that, you can customize your Calendly embed. If you have any questions around this, let me know. I can also make a video on how to actually adapt it a little bit more to the outwards div, but I think this is good for beginners now. And if you have any questions, put them in the comments below. See you on the next video. Bye-bye.